Hey there, so I'm super excited because we're talking erectile dysfunction today. And really what I want to spend energy on is helping you to understand erectile function. So as we go through these next few weeks, we understand the solutions to erectile dysfunction. Okay, so let's just get rid of the myths out there. So the myth is that erectile dysfunction only happens to older gentlemen. It's not true. We're seeing it more and more in younger people. And what we're finding in young men, men under the age of 40, is that not only are you having erectile dysfunction, but some of you have severe erectile dysfunction. So I know, what do? We rush and get the blue pill, or we go to the gas station and get some herbal remedies. Well, let's understand why and how it happens so we can come up with some natural solutions and actually fix the problem instead of taking these pills the rest of our life. Deal? Okay, so stick with me and that's what we're gonna do. So today, we're gonna talk about the anatomy of an erection. I think it's important. You know, you sit through sex ed, no one ever talks about how these things happen. So let's really dive deep into how erectile function even takes place. Because honestly, it's all about blood flow. So that means that we're gonna talk about how to improve blood flow down there. All right, so what we've got in here are basically little lakes or little sacs of arteries that have to fill up and become engorged with blood. I think too many people think it's a bone. Too many people think it's a muscle. No, there is erectile tissue there and it's gotta get filled with blood. So if there's no blood flow there, or if the blood can't get trapped in, then we don't have an erection. So let me go ahead and demonstrate. Now, I want you to also point out, see this green in here? This is representative of a vein, the dorsal vein. And unfortunately, if the dorsal vein doesn't get closed off, what happens? All of that blood rushes back out. So you can get one, but you can't keep one. So let's demonstrate. All right, so take a look here. Take a look, and as you can see, these arteries are actually starting to expand. So what has to happen is they not only have to relax enough to expand, the blood has to go in and it has to get trapped. So now we can see the dorsal vein is getting tightened off, and now all of a sudden we have this amazing erection. So what's happening now? Okay, the dorsal vein is opening up, we've got leakage, and this is what happens when you get a fantastic erection and can't keep it. So what we're going to do is spend a lot of time talking about blood flow. Blood flow, how can we increase blood flow, and how can we trap the blood in there once we have it? All right, so stay tuned. So there you have it. Now you understand how erectile function takes place. You understand that there are arteries in the erectile tissue that have to fill up like sacs. And if they don't, you cannot have an erection. So yes, it's impacted by the brain, it's impacted by the diet, it's impacted by environment, it's impacted by what we're thinking, it's impacted on how someone touches us, but the whole thing is that blood flow has to be there. So let's really start diving into how to improve the blood flow. So that's what we've got next. So like this video, share this video, subscribe so that you know when we're going live, when we got new videos, because we are on a trajectory to demystify erectile dysfunction, and I can help you figure out what's causing it so that you can make steps to fix it. Wouldn't that be great that you don't have to pop pills each and every time? I got you. No worries.